Hello friends, let us see how we can design this kettle in Fusion 360. We are going to use the options sweep, loft and combine. Let's take the sketching plane. I'm going to draw a vertical line. Let's dimension it as 150. This is the only dimension I'm going to give. All other will be given randomly. Here I'm going to draw this arcs. I can also use spline option for this, but as I want to give tangency constraints, I'm using arc command. So in the sketch palette, I'm going to give the constraints. I have selected tangency for these arcs, and the arc and the line I have given this constraint. Now I'm giving horizontal constraint for this line, and I'm going to draw another line to close this figure. Now go to stop sketch and I'm going to revolve this. So I have this figure of the pot. Now I need to draw the spout. So for this I'm going to take the same sketching plane as before, and here I'm going to use spline option. So I have created this spline using these points. If I need more points, I can add to the spline. I can also adjust these points. I can right click this and select insert spline fit point and insert a point randomly, and using that point as anchor, I can make changes to this spline. So I'm switching off this body so that I can clearly move them. Now I'm going to use this plane along path. You might be wondering how this tool is here. I'm resetting all my panel customization, and here you will find this plane along path. As we need to use it many times, I'm right clicking and I'm clicking on pin to toolbar so that this comes on the toolbar. Here I'm going to click on this spline, and here I'm constructing many planes, and on these planes I will be drawing my cross sections. So I have totally created 6 planes which are all lying in the direction of this spline. So here I'm going to draw a circle. This will be kind of an opening. Here again, these circles will be larger because this will be the place from where the tea will be poured out from the jar. So the advantage of Fusion is that you can actually change these cross sections randomly. That also we are going to see. Right now this is the shape. Now I hope it is clear how we are going to create it. So here I'm using the loft option. So what loft option does is it blends all these structures together. So you can see over here, this object is not visible, it is saying, because the bodies I have hidden. Here I'm going to take new body option, as this spout should be in a different body from the pot that has been created. So this is how I've got the spout. Now I feel that this is too much below, so I'll be moving this above. You can see here how randomly I can move the spline and these sketches also. So I'm highlighting all these sketches. Only this spline has moved because there was no anchor point to this. But now I can move this circles also and the center points also. I can keep changing the diameter till I get the required shape. If you see, all these tools will be moving randomly and spontaneously. You can see the changes. Like if I'm increasing it or decreasing it, I can see this change in the body immediately. I can also change the distance of this. Like I can edit this feature of this plane, I can move it and I can see the difference. So here I have adjusted it as I need it. So now I'm switching off all these sketches. This is going to be my shape. Now let's see that there are two bodies. One is the spout and one is the pot. But here there is no cut. So I need actually a cut so that the tea has to be poured out. So for this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use combine option and I'm going to select this as a target body and the spout as a tool body, and I'm going to keep this tool. Let's see what happens if I do not keep this tool. You can see here a hole is created, but my tool has been removed. That is my body too. The spout has been removed. So this I do not want to happen. So I'm going to keep this tool, and here actually a hole has been created, but the spout still exists. Now I'm going to use the shell command and I'm going to make a hole inside it. That is, I'm going to remove the inside portion and keep only 1 mm thickness around it. So here it is, inside it is hollow and it is having two sides open. So this my body one is ready. I can do the same thing for this also, but let's see what is going to happen if I'm going to give the shell option. So here you can see that this shell option now is going to be applied only for body 1. So body 2 remains intact, but we should not keep this extra portion of the spout. So what I'm going to do is, instead of this, I'm going to make a revolve cut so that even that spout portion is also removed from inside. Let's take the sketching plane. And here I'm going to draw a profile which will be inside this pot. So here I'm projecting this outside line. P is the shortcut command. And I'm going to draw line outside this. Here you can see I have left some gap. Now I'm going to dimension this as 2 mm, which will be the shell diameter. So here I'm going to use the offset tool. So before that, let me trim off this extra portion. So I'll be removing all these extra lines. Now I can offset these things. So O is the shortcut for offset. I'm giving this offset distance as 2 mm. So now you can see I'm going to move this outside because I want the top portion to be open. This can be of any shape as long as it's outside. So I have given it this way. And I'm going to select. I'm just switching off these bodies and I'm going to select these sketches. So directly I'll be going to create. Instead of stop sketch, I can directly go and will be out of the sketch. And this is going to be my axis. And I'm clicking OK. Now, you can see here objects to cut. So when I expand, you can see that both body 1 and body 2 are selected. If body 2 is not selected, let's see how it's going to look. Now you can see this is what is the desired shape. So if body 2 wasn't selected, the spout would have had this extra portion lying inside. So here I need to draw the handle of it. Like how I have created first spout, here I have drawn this arc and on this plane through the path I have created this circle. But here I am going to use sweep option as there is only one cross section. So this is a circle and it is uniform throughout the arc. So this is how I have created now. You can see how it is going to look. Now if you see inside, this part has come out. That is this handle part, which is body 4. This has come out. Now what I am going to do is, this cut that we have created using the revolve option, I am going to move beyond all these options in the modal tree. So I can actually drag it. Can hold on it and I can drag it as the last step. So now this operation will be performed beyond all the operations. So but here in the objects to cut, it is going to cut only body 1 and body 2. So I have to again select body 4. So now you can see even the handle portion has been cut. Now our teapot is ready.